Karen, Karen, you will be able to use a computer to analyze the project activity. And why there is a need to use a computer system? Because then the calculations or the permutations and combinations becomes difficult in the bigger projects. And it is then easier for the organization to conduct a parallel project analysis on the number of different projects. So whenever there is a difficulty to plan, schedule, budget, control the project activities within the without a manual technique, we are then bent towards to use the computer-based project management system, and we need a computer. Therefore, the advantage that this type of system holds is it does the problem at high speed, means you are able to get your project analysis at a very good rate, right? It doesn't take much of the time, doesn't involve complex calculations. You don't have to use your mind out to perform the calculations on the project. So then it does is able to store and process large volume of the data. So if we are working on the number of different projects, then it is for sure that we have to handle multiple projects together, as well as if there are number of different projects together, then each project would contain numerous volume or the numerous amount of data. So in order to use such a software where there is an advantage that we are able to process the large amount of data together for the number of projects that are running parallelly. And then the results that we get from processing the data are the accurate results, where there is a very little possibility of the human error. Human error would only arise if the values which are entered into the system are incorrect, or the allocations or the matching from the resources to the tasks and from the task to the resources is not done properly. So that might be the possibility of the human error. Otherwise, this is a one man's job. So there is no need to have a number of people working in the project analysis, like the subordinates or different people which are looking after the events and the activities. So with one single software and one trained person who can easily work on the software, can do the calculations or the project analysis. The essential requirements which are there in the software must be to handle the multiple projects together. So we have to invest one time on the project management system software. Thereby, we have to purchase such software which is able to handle multiple. Second, it should generate different type of reports. So those different type of reports could be in the form of graphs, or could be in the form of histograms, could be the line graphs, could be the Gantt charts, then line of balance technique. It could be like easily read and understood from the report that what is happening inside the project. Then capacity to set the goals and tasks for the purpose of analysis, right? like we are using the Gantt charts, thereby setting the baseline for the progress of the project. And generally, when we do use the Gantt chart, we set our tasks along the horizontal line where we are checking the progress of the project. So this software system should have the capacity to set the timelines to achieve the progress on the project. And the software should be such that it should support the different type of file formatting where it is required. So for example, whenever we are using the CAD software, we generally need to import or export the drawings into the analysis software. So in the one software, we are making the drawing or the design, and then we are taking the drawing into the another software to check upon its analysis. So such documents where there are a lot of people where they are involved into the in the project, and where if everybody is working on the software, so they will be having their own systems. So that time their file formats should be supported in each of the system with the project executives. Further, the project management system software should be easy to learn and implement. So it means that the online tutorials must be available wherever, whenever it is needed to train the employees, and the software should be very easy and could be self understood on the basis of the tutorials or anything, any material, any reading material which is available. So this software helps to solve wide a range of problems. It is able to produce a number of different reports. So I'll discuss it further. How many reports can be generated, or what are the examples of the reports that we are talking about here? And the extensive online help must be available at all the times. So if even if there is an update with the system of the software, then the update tutorials should be easily available on all the websites for the software help to check upon the update. Coming to the next slide, the different type of software packages that are there for use is the Microsoft Project. So this is the list of the different type of softwares. So generally, we would be discussing about the Microsoft Project in detail, and the other softwares are the Harvard Total Project Manager, Project Planner, Prism. Prism is popularly used in Indian CPMS, Computerized Project Management System. InstaPlan is another software which is there by Wipro, is a popular Indian CPMS. Other project planner names are QuickNet, PC Projects, ProMan, and the Project Scheduler. So you can see the name simplifies the meaning of the work that we have to carry out. It's all related to the project, and thereby we can easily understand from the name the software packages which are available in the market. We can use them for the project management system, or the project managing, or the management of the project. These details, whatever details we have then for carry out the project analysis, the Prism software which is there automatically schedules the activities based upon the resource requirement. So we need to make or compose a resource pool in the software. So resource pool is actually the number of resources that we allocate to the tasks that are there in the project. And Prism also supports a powerful graphic generator that provides the user with many useful charts like bar charts, time cost trade-off curves, histograms, cash flow graphs, network diagrams, and others. So we don't have a licensed project management system here. So I would be teaching you certain few examples about how you can actually see the progress of your project. And we would be using Microsoft Work Manager, where it is provided with the Microsoft Office Manager, sorry. It is provided with Microsoft Excel sheets. And the Excel sheets thus supports the numerous type of calculations. And it also generate the different type of reports. So the reports, generally we have bar charts, Gantt charts, Pareto analysis, and histograms that we can use, that we can generate in the Microsoft Excel. Now, a detailed discussion about the Microsoft project. It has these components. It has Gantt chart, project baseline. We need to understand each of the purpose of using the different type of components that is there in a project management software. So in a Microsoft project, we have 9 components by different definitions and the purpose of using each of these. So it's a very popular software among the project management software packages, and it does support the areas like scheduling, budgeting, resource management, charts, performance monitoring, risk management, analysis, reports, and communication. As well as it also provides the sharing of resources between the projects and export import of the project data among the multiple projects that are being handled together. So a Gantt chart is very similar to an LOB chart. So this is the LOB chart. It is very similar to a Gantt chart, whereby we check the progress of the project along the timeline. So starting from January 2020, we can see the progress of the chart till December 2020 or December 2021. So the next component that we have in Microsoft project is the project baseline. Generally, if we see a project plan is finalized after a lot of discussions, corrections, modifications, and revisions, whenever they are required, once the project plan is finalized, it is to be stored as a reference so that we can use it into the other projects. So Microsoft project uses a baseline for storing the project plan so that it can be used as a reference. Although these definitions has been there or has come out just because these were stored or used in the project and these were stored as the reference to make you understand about how things go about in the project management software. And the baseline is a project plan which contains the original estimates for the tasks, resources, assignments, and cost. So thereby this data, as per the plan, like the start and the finish dates of the task, the duration of the task, the split in the task, and the cost of the task, etc. These are captured in the baseline. So the project baseline has the starting and the ending dates, the duration, the split in the task, the cost of the task. Now, split in the task. The next part is the splitting the tasks. It means when you have started a project. Meanwhile, there is a task inside the project under the implementation process which needs to be splitted. And why would the splitting be there? Why would we think of doing splitting? Because if a person who is attending a particular task requires a month's duration of leave, then we can wait for the person to come after the 1 month. Thereby, for example, if the person was working in the project requires has applied for the leave from 15th November to 15th of December, thereby into the project management software, we can simply split the task starting from 15th November till 15th of December, allotting it a break of 1 month. And then after 1 month, when the person rejoins, the task can then be continued with the remaining portion of the time. So thereby, the splitting component is there into the project management system, because the time would not stop. We have allotted a certain amount of time for that task, which is to be done by a particular person. When the person takes a time off, then we can actually split the task until that time when the person would rejoin and continue on the project. The next component it does have is the schedule the processing. So schedule processing means linking of the different tasks which are there in a project, right? So a proper link is to be established between the different tasks, and the project schedule can be altered suitably wherever there are changes in the starting and the completion times of the task. And certain relationships are then required to build up between the different tasks. The relations are defined in the form of finish to start, start to start, finish to finish, and start to finish. For example, if there is a relation like finish to start relationship between the two tasks, so it means that one task cannot start until the another task finishes. And in start to start relationship is one in which the one task cannot start until the another task starts. So schedule processing is making the relationships between the tasks. Project cost estimation. So this is the foremost requirement where we need to calculate the cost which is there in the project, and it is the estimate that we have to make when we are implementing the project. So first we had planned the project, we had estimated the cost which will be involved to carry out all the tasks, all the activities, and the cost. Then during the implementation of the project, these costs which are planned can vary. So this variance in the costs can then be used by can then be analyzed by using the project cost estimation, where the project cost is arrived by the costs which are allotted to the individual tasks. So every activity that consume the resources, the costs are assigned to the resources, and resources are in turn assigned to the tasks. The cost of the task is then arrived by the software by multiplying the resource required to complete the task with the cost of the resource. Now, these resources, these are taken from the resource pool, which is created. So a resource pool is created, which would then include all the resources which are used up in the project. Generally, these resources are grouped into two categories: the work resources, which have the people and the equipment which are assigned to the task, and the material resources. And the material resources are generally related to the material, which are the supplies, the stock, and the other consumable items that is used to complete the task. So all this resource pool, where it has material resources and the work resources, all these details are entered in the resource sheet. So whenever you would work on the project with any company, they must be having the resource sheet, where you will see the different type of resources. So generally, it is not fixed that we would have only two types of resources. They could vary with name and the requirement. Monitoring the progress of the project. So this is actually the earned value analysis, and is also called as the budgeted cost of the work performed. So this would actually compare the estimated and the actual parameters. And this difference or the variance between the baseline, which is the estimated, and the actual performance or the actual parameters, can then be calculated, which would indicate whether the project is being implemented as planned or not. Then there are two type of variances or the differences that would generally be seen into the project. The first one is the cost variance, and the second one is the schedule variance. The cost variance is the difference between the tasks which are which were planned at the cost, at a certain cost, and is compared with the actual cost during the implementation or during the ongoing work. And the schedule variance is the difference between the actual progress and the scheduled progress of the task. The actual progress would always be different from the scheduled progress or the scheduled task or the timetable that you have generated. Like, for example, if I have planned your class at 11 a.m., I would not be able to start my class at 11 a.m. That might be because of the certain problems that we face, right? So I've started the lecture at 11, 8 a.m. This might be the case. So the planning and scheduling of the class is different. So there is a difference or gap of or a variance of 8 minutes between the planning and the scheduling of the class, starting of the class, and actually planned the class at 11 a.m. and started the class at 11, 8 a.m. The next one is the resource leveling. And so the resource leveling actually means the fixing the time schedules. So we have a certain, the entry inputs into the software. We can actually select the manual leveling and or the automatic leveling. So in the manual leveling, we will enter the values such as the project must finish on at this time. The class must start on 11 a.m. on this date at 11 a.m. So the project must finish as late as possible from the start date. The project must start as soon as possible from the finish date. So these numbers can be fixed in the Microsoft project software. The resource pool is a project file that contains the resource information of an organization. main idea which is there behind creating a resource pool is to facilitate the sharing of resources among the multiple projects. The organization can handle the multiple projects at a very single time. It means number of projects are running parallelly. It becomes efficient to distribute the resource from the resource pool instead of allocating the resources from the individual's projects exclusively. So there is a data set, there is a Bible, or there is a bank that is created into the project management software from where the resources could be allocated. And if there is a way to actually use the resources into the multiple projects, their implementation can then be numbered from 0 to 1,000 in order to rank them in order of their relative importance. So I know a task which can be done by executed by a machine does not require a labor. So I'll keep that machinery at a much higher rank than the labor. Or I would require a labor where I don't require the machinery. So I would rank the labor according to that. Next is the reports. The reports, I was telling you that it should have the capability to generate different type of reports. By reports, we can simplify the progression in the project. So there are different type of reports. For example, in the overview reports, we have the project summary, the top level tasks, the critical tasks, and the milestones that we have to achieve, the goals. In the current activity reports, we have the unstarted tasks. So some tasks, they start, and some tasks, they don't start until some resource allocation is pending or the material is pending. So the resource allocation has the material and the work resources, both comes under them. The tasks which are about to start, the tasks that are in progress to completed tasks, the tasks which should have started, the slipping tasks. Then there are the cost reports, where we have the reports regarding the cash flow, budget, over budget tasks, over budget resources, and the earned value. Assignment reports are reports where generally we do the allotment thing. Like we have 5 people in a project. So the people named from A to E. So what would A do in the project? What would E do in the project? And if A has started the project at 10:05 a.m., the E must start the project at 12:20 a.m. And the to-do list, which is then assigned or allotted against each of the person and the over allocated resources. So it means like we have reports related to who does what and when, what is to-do list, and over allocated resources, which means including the starting time and the finish time, the duration and the delay, if there is a delay. So this is overall about the all the components that is there in the project management software. And I think it does a lot more than simple paper planning or the manual analysis. So automatic analysis or a computerized analysis is better than a manual analysis. But to understand the automatic analysis or the computerized analysis, you must be aware about the manual analysis. So there is a base that you have in you to actually progress on the computerized based analysis, which is called as the computerized based project management system. Now the next and the last topic is the enterprise-wise project management system. It is the same category of the project management, but in this category where we can monitor from one central location. So if we are hiring people from other countries apart except from India to work upon the projects. So then we can have people monitoring from America if you are working on a project in India. We have people from Europe to work upon a project if we are having a people in India. So we can then have a different location of the server, a different location of the project management system. We can have the project manager working with the team from a very different location. So we have, and we have different number of team members all together from different locations. So this could be managed from one central location, monitored or managed from one central location, but we could have a team which is there into the project from different locations, right? So it would then allow us to plan together from different locations, then would help us to collaborate in order to do a collaborative planning among the different project managers and project executives, thus facilitating the web-based resource management and reporting. Right. So everything is managed along the web. And this would thus allow the continuous interaction between the different personnel involved in the project execution at the different project sites. Means whoever is in charge of the actual execution of the projects at the different location assess the website and collect the required data sent by the project manager. The teams which are there at the different locations would then actually submit the work times, the resources, requirements back to the project manager through the internet server, and after assessing the responses from the different members, the project manager can revise the estimates if needed and resubmit the revised plan of action to the teams. So this is a continuous interaction between the different team members. So this is how it will work. There is this project manager, it communicates on the single site to the project management software. The project manager interns with the internet server. So this is work with the three components between the internet server, project management software, and the project manager is a cycle. And there is, then the internet server has a two-way communication with the three different teams, web team one, web team two, and web team three. And internet server has a single-way communication with the project manager. Project manager commands to the project management software. The project management software commands to the internet server. Internet server would tell the responses to the web team 1, 2, and 3. This is all about the enterprise-wise project management.